In April of last year, everyone launched the Awatu, which further enhanced the shooting capabilities of PV drones, but many friends who play with carrier and freestyle drones also hope to have the same aircraft camera shooting effect as Awatu and have been looking forward to the legendary O3 Air unit. Today, it has finally arrived this time. I also installed the O3 Pro on multiple devices. Compared to the previous O3 Air unit, the installation difference is not that big. But the camera's screw spacing has changed. It's a bit wider than before because this time the lens module is relatively large. It means that most of the previous aircraft entering the frame cannot fix this lens, but today iFlight has also launched new models. To adapt to the new O3 Air unit like my original DJI C5, it can only be barely fitted to suitable after installing the O3. I immediately sold my GoPro. Because I think the O3 Pro, which can shoot DLOM, can basically replace action cameras, reducing the weight of an action camera, can greatly improve the aircraft's maneuverability and endurance. This is a revolutionary change for freestyle drone shooting this time. I also assembled a small 1.6-inch freestyle drone. This drone weighs just over 100 grams. About the same as the weight of an action camera, but it has the same image quality performance as a Watu. This may be the future indoor artifact, stage artifact. Then my friends will say, I've sold everything. Will there be a problem with insufficient image quality in the future if I rely on this O3 Pro for shooting? Of course, some of our professional shoots will still use larger equipment to compensate the combination of large and small. This is a complete workflow. In addition, this time the O3 transmission also has a lap version, which is an extremely lightweight version that can be installed on some small toy planes and racing planes. But the camera screw spacing is the same as the Pro version. We need to wait for some adaptations from these aircraft manufacturers. At the same time, these two transmissions also support the new low-latency racing mode, which can be used by racing masters. I just want to share some of the substantial changes that this transmission brings to our players or practitioners. Finally, let's take a look at the signal performance of the All3 and O4 transmissions. Everyone is more concerned about this issue. We can take a direct look because I took off from the same location and flew to the same location with the same battery. We can directly compare the power differences of multiple devices. The above is some of my evaluation and experience of this O4 transmission. After everyone gets started, we can communicate more.